Hi, welcome to Genius Lounge. I'm your host, Matt Troutman. Genius Lounge is a place where you can get to know the technology that you already own. I'm super excited to announce that we're partnering with Kathi Lipp and the Clutter-Free Academy to bring you this next series of videos. Kathi's book, Clutter-Free, has been an inspiration to so many people in decluttering their homes and their workspaces. Kathi recently approached me about decluttering our digital lives, and I thought that was a fantastic idea, and so that's where we bring in this idea right here. So today, we're gonna teach you about being a clutter-free genius and starting to set up your iCloud photo library. I will mention that this video is geared towards people who have iPhones or iOS devices like iPads or iPod Touches. Now, if you have an Android device, you can click the little card up in the corner, or there's a link down in the description, and you can find the equivalent Android version of this particular video. We want to make sure to cover all of our bases because we know that not all of the world runs on iPhones, and we want to make sure that everyone can become clutter-free. You might wonder why you would want your photos up in the cloud, which, in case you didn't know, the cloud is just another fancy term for somebody else's computer. That being said, in case you lose your phone, drop it in the toilet, which happens way more than people like to admit, or the phone just dies randomly, we want to make sure that you have all of those precious memories so that you can get to them. And once they're in the cloud, they're accessible from any host of devices, whether that be an Android phone, an iPhone, or even a computer. Now, storage on iCloud can be tricky because it can fill up quickly. The good news is, expanding on the free storage from Apple won't break the bank. Apple currently offers a range of capacities that will likely fit your budget. And as you can see, I can go in here and I can check out the different offerings that Apple offers. I can choose from 50 gigabytes, 200 gigabytes, or 2 terabytes, which for most people will be overkill. However, for me and my family, it actually works out great. Currently, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to stick with the 5 gigabyte plan. And enough about talking about iCloud Photo Library, let's enable it. So from settings, I'm gonna go ahead and go into my iCloud account. I'm gonna go into Photos, and I'm going to turn on my iCloud Photo Library. You'll see that that takes a couple of moments to turn on, and once I do, I'll have a couple of options there, Optimize iPhone Storage, and Download and Keep Originals as options. I'm going to go ahead and leave this on Optimize iPhone Storage now. And the nice part here is that if my iPhone is running low on storage and I have more photos than will fit on my phone in the cloud, it will only keep low resolution photos on my phone, but the full resolution versions are still up in the cloud. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and jump into my Photos application right here. And I notice here are all of the photos that are on my phone. And at the bottom here, I see that it's uploading 74 items. Now, you might notice that I've only got 58 photos, but there are 74 items uploading. That indicates that there may be some photos in the trash, but it syncs everything across all of your devices. That's one important thing to note. With iCloud Photo Library, if you delete a photo on your iPhone and you have your iPad also synced with iCloud Photo Library, the photo will be deleted from that device as well. So just be aware, changes that you make apply to all of your devices, not just the device that you're on. That's the benefit and the beauty of iCloud Photo Library. It's also something to be careful of. So that's a quick overview of getting your photos and videos into iCloud Photo Library. Once again, if you have an Android device and you wanted to see the Google Photos equivalent, jump on over to our Android version of this particular video and check that out. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to our channel, hit that little red button down below, and if you want to get notifications each time we post a new video, ring that little bell and you'll get a notification inside your app or in your email every time we post new content. Thank you so much for joining us. I'm Matt Troutman, and I'll see you next time on Genius Lounge.